You're here at ISE 2017 with the HowToAV team, and we're talking to all the professionals about audio visual tech. If you want to talk to experts over at the show, join InfoComm. And if InfoComm need an expert, they're going to talk to Chuck Espinoza, who is one of their lead trainers. Chuck, welcome to the show and welcome to HowToAV.
Thank you very much.
So today we're going to be talking about audio system design and what our considerations are. Chuck, I know you've been doing a seminar on that. What can you tell us that you can squeeze into 3 minutes for our audience?
What can I squeeze into 3 minutes? Well, the first thing, when you're building an audio system, commercial audio or a live audio event system, you really want to make sure you look at your specifications. Make sure your microphones match up with your mixer for your applications that you need. Make sure your amps are going to be, have enough power to drive the speakers you need. You're not going to be pushing them to 11. You really want to look at what equipment is going to be right for the application. And a lot of that you'll be able to tell through the specifications.
And there are so many systems. It isn't just one sound system. And we know from so much experience that the sound system can often be the forgotten piece of the kit.
Yeah, it's funny that if you have a sound system that's malfunctioning, a lot of times they'll just turn it down and accept it. Or if it doesn't sound quite so good. You know, your video system, if you turn it on, you have a picture, it works. If you turn it off, it works. Hey, great. Your audio system, it could have all kinds of weird crackles, or, you know, that microphone just hasn't worked quite right. We don't understand it. There could be a lot of things, and it's just an accepted thing, and, you know, turn it off, out of sight, out of mind, so to speak. So what we really want to make sure we do is put the right pieces together that are meant to work with the other pieces for that specific application. We want to make sure that the gear fits the application.
And we were speaking a moment ago about the difference really in considering residential audio in the home and then on a larger scale, say in a boardroom or in a conference suite. So what's those major considerations that we need to think about there?
Well, there are a couple things. When you're thinking about your home, usually you're thinking about your home theater, and you have this beautiful screen that's perfect eye level with your couch, and you have speakers that are set up just the right spot to hit your ears right at that couch, and they surround you and give you this feeling of being immersed in the entertainment experience. And a lot of times people will spec a commercial system like that. You know, a CEO gets a new theater and he thinks, oh, I want this experience in my boardroom. I want my presentations to have this wow that I get from the movie. And they want a surround sound system in their boardroom because that's what sounds good at home. And as an AV integrator, we try to educate our clients as to the differences between the systems and the things that make that immersion so specific, and how much do we need surround sound for your PowerPoint presentation? Is it going to be that important? And if your room's so big, the physics of your room mean that this person isn't going to be able to hear the front if we have different channels, that's something we really have to take into consideration. And you know, I'm glad that curved screen looks great in your home theater. Please don't put that in your boardroom, because other than the two or three people right in front, everyone else is going to have a very bad experience.
And I guess also sound and acoustics aren't the same thing. And just specifying a system and expecting it to work in one environment and in another environment just isn't right, is it?
Oh, no. Sound is very, very fluid. And working with that fluidity and the different rooms, the different things in the room that soak up sound and reflect sound. You can have the same sound system in a room that just has more glass or a tile floor or a bigger table area. It's a completely different experience. You get different reflections. You get different interactions between the sound waves. Just the fact that they have the same dimensions, height, width, and length, gives you a couple inherent things. But everything in that room reacts with the sound wave. Sound is energy, and people don't realize after I stop talking, that sound still bounces around. It's not audible, but that energy bounces around. And the more energy you put in, the more reflections and interaction you get. So having microphones in a boardroom, for example, I really like them on the table. I want it close to someone's mouth. I don't want it on the ceiling, where it's right next to an air conditioning unit or a light that's going to buzz because that air conditioning unit is closer. So using the physics of the room, I want to lower those mics as much as possible, as close to my mouth as I possibly can get them. And again, those measurements can be found in the specifications as to what that microphone will do with that certain sound pressure level.
Specifications on sound systems, specifications on products can be a lot to take in. Best tip, surely, is speak to the manufacturers. They've all got some great experts there who are there to help you out, not to simply sell your product, right?
Oh yeah, the manufacturers will actually tell you what the specifications mean, where to look at what specification for what type of quality you're looking from that piece of equipment, whether it's loudness from a speaker or clarity from a speaker, different things, or efficiency of that speaker. And same thing with microphones. A microphone is just a speaker backwards. I mean, I'm talking into it, it's taking these sound waves and turning them into electrical impulses. It goes through the system, goes to the speaker where it gets electrical impulses and turns it into sound waves. And it, as much as we put these things together and look at all the specs and the numbers involved with this guy, it's going to boil down to, as good as it gets, this is still analog and it still has to hear a vibration.
Designing an audio system can be truly complex. The HowToAV team is full of AV and audio experts. If you've got any questions, you need any advice on audio system design, leave us a question in the comments section below and we'll get straight back to you. Thanks for watching. Chuck, thanks for joining us. See you again soon on HowToAV.tv. We'll be right back.